Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to give you exposition of the most difficult parable, the parable of the 10 virgins. And it's not easy to understand unless you have the knowledge of Trinity, which are explained in part 1. Now in part 2, I want to explain what are the people Jesus is talking about. That means one with the holding lamps in their hands. And people who hold the lamps are the twice born people. This one and this one. They both have lamps in their hands, and because they are twice born, so their lights are lit, both of them. This light is not lit, which is this one, once born people. They are lamps without light. They are no good. So Jesus is not talking about these. It's talking about this one and this one. They are doubting and they are clever, psychic. And these are pneumatic, sealed to serve God. So pneumatic are the one who are devoted to God. So they have the oil lamp full of the oil, plenty of oil. Oil means faith in God. While the doubting one, they are clever. They think, you know, they are psychic and they seek the praises of men as well. Whereas those who are bound to seek to serve God, they are solitary and they glorify our Father. They don't glorify themselves. They don't seek their praises. As Peter told the people who, when he healed the person, that we are ordinary men like you. We are not special. So they are their nature, you know. Whereas the psychic, they want to show of their own that they are special people. So these psychic, they lack the qualities. Remember the Samaritan woman at the well? She was pneumatic and she had overpowered all the 5 temptations of the heart. And the first temptation is the seed, the ego of the seed. There are 3 of ego, 2 of mind. So this seed, ego, then the first one, the physical fitness. When you go to a rabbi, he tells you how to keep your body fit. You may become a wrestler, a footballer. Then you have the ego that I'm a big footballer or wrestler. Then you have ego of spiritual knowledge, which you learn through book knowledge. As in Jerusalem, people were reading books. They had no knowledge in spirit. So these are 3 of ego and 2 are of mind. Mind are greed and temptation, worldly temptation. These are of mind. So if you are free of those 5, or if you overpower them 5, then you are sealed to serve God. Then you have plenty of oil in your lamp. But if you are short of any one of them, then your lamp is not suitable or does not have enough oil. So you can't marry the bridegroom. So 5s who are perfect in their moral laws and spiritual principle, they got the bridegroom. So 5 of the temptation of the heart, which they have overpowered. Samaritan woman was one of them. And the last husband of the Samaritan woman was this knowledge, spiritual knowledge, which she had learned in spirit. In spirit she learned and she was humble, listening to Jesus. Whereas in Jerusalem, they were reading Torah and other books to attain the spiritual knowledge. And Jesus was standing in front of them, and they said, "Oh, Messiah will come in the house of David." And Jesus said, "What about the one standing in front of you?" They could not recognize him. So that was the husband which the Jewish people could not overpower. So they were subject to this defect, ego of the letters, as you find them, the university professors. When you meet them, they have ego of the letters. They don't want to talk with me because they think they know more than I do. So if you want to be perfect, then you have to overpower both ego and what we call mind. Mind. In Arabic it is called nafs, and in Punjabi we call it man. This is called home, ego. You must overpower ego to have awakened mind. When you get awakened mind, it is tempted to the worldly temptation, which you should overpower and put it under wisdom, pneumatic. You should become pneumatic, sealed to serve God. Then you have enough oil to meet the bridegroom. So with this introduction, this parable won't be difficult now to understand. So now I go through it and you will easily understand. The parable of the 10 virgins. Then the royal kingdom of God. In Jesus we are royal kingdom of God, not of heaven. Heaven, kingdom of heaven is the regime of the rabbi. Whereas the royal kingdom of God is the regime of the royal priest. So it will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps, because both people of spirit, psychic as well as pneumatic, their lamps are both lit. They are aware. They are men of spirit, twice born. They were twice born and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish, governed by the wishes of their mind. 5 were wise, sealed to serve God only, pneumatic. So 5 were psychic, 5 were pneumatic. For when the foolish took their lamps, that means the psychic one, they took no oil with them. Now these clever people, psychic people, they were clever, psychic. But the wise, pneumatic, sealed to serve God, took flasks of oil, then with plenty of faith in God, with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, they all became drowsy and slept. Because we don't know when you will be called to meet the bridegroom. It comes of its own accord. We can't know the time when it will come. When you are united with God, you don't know. But at midnight, there was a cry. "Here is the bridegroom. Come out to meet him." Then all those virgins rose. Virgin mean they are both solitary, my people. Whether you are psychic or pneumatic, you are solitary. Arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish, clever psychic people said to the wise pneumatics, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise answered, saying, "Since there will not be enough for us and for you, go rather to the dealers and buy for yourself. Now this is very interesting. Now faith is the oil in the lamp in God, is to be earned by an individual. Nobody can give you, you know. You have to do it yourself, earn it yourself. And you cannot transfer faith to another person. That means you can't give oil to another person lamp. And while they were going to buy, the bridegroom came. And those who were ready went in with him. That means people think, you know, leave it, you know, tomorrow. But they don't keep themselves ready for bridegroom. And these are the psychic one, you know, leave it tomorrow, never mind. But those who are pneumatic, they work hard day and night to earn faith and oil. Those who were ready went in with him to the marriage feast, and the door was shut. The psychic repent for their over cleverness, and it is too late to regain faith in this life period. Afterward, the other virgins came also, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. You know, the psychic, they always like to exercise their psychic wits. When Paul was accused by the Jews, then these temple people, they took with them special people, psychic, to render praise to the Pilate and to the kings, Roman kings, so that by calling them Lord, 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 they will impress him and they will get the judgment in their favor, as they do in courts these days. The judges are your servant, but you call them Lord, because to boost their ego and get favors from them. So these people, you know, psychic, they played their trick. Lord, Lord, open to us. Who is Lord in the royal kingdom of God? Nobody. But he answered, truly I say to you, I do not know you. Because there is no Lord in the royal kingdom of God. In the royal kingdom of God, we have Father and we have sons. Sons have the right to enter into the Father's vineyard through the narrow gate. Why these? If you call God a Lord, then you become a slave. When you become a slave, you are kept outside the house. That is what happened. They were saying, Lord, Lords. They were kept outside. Get out of the gate. Don't come near the gate. So these people, when they churches, you know, they say, Lord, Jesus, Lord, this thing, they are put outside the royal kingdom of God. And they can keep on saying Lord and Lord as if he will be pleased with their psychic tricks. No way. The psychics even tried their tricks of praising our Father. But he could not be tricked by their flatter of Lord, Lord, etc. God is our Father and we are his sons. Whilst the lords have slaves and they are not allowed into the house but kept outside as the psychic are kept in churches. So in churches, you know, you see them, these people, psychic, priest, saying Lord, 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 they are kept outside the royal kingdom of God. So they themselves can't enter into the royal kingdom of God, how can they let their congregation enter? By addressing our Father a Lord, the psychic impress upon the once born people and they form a following. You know, blind, only blind people follow other. But in Jesus we are to be solitary in order to enter the vineyard of our Father, where our Bridegroom, Christ Jesus, is sitting, awaiting for us. These psychic know fully that God is our Father, but they address Him Lord in order to lord over the once-born devotees or the followers, you know, they make a following as Pope, and enjoy their self-praises, such as fathers among them, church fathers, you know, fake fathers. Watch therefore for you, now neither the day nor the hour. So the day when you are married to our Father is not known to you. He will call you when He is pleased with your service. So you need to be Son of the Most High. Don't call our Father a Lord, otherwise you will be thrown out of the vineyard of our Father. Most of the Samaritans were pneumatics, and the woman at the well, John 4, presents a typical pneumatic man. She was a man because he was solitary, master of his own destiny. That Christ Jesus fished into the royal kingdom of God. We are fishers of men, spiritually solitary people, and not of the women who follow others, such as Pope. Pope has so many women. They are kept outside the vineyard. They can't enter it because only the solitary men can enter. In Jesus, everyone is to give his own account to God. So nobody can give your account to God. So Pope, these dog-collar priests in churches, and those, everybody who put on this uniform and is a priest, he is Antichrist. Because in Jesus, we have been made the sons of the Most High, the royal priests. So royal priests don't need whitewashed cups. They do not need these dog collars. Dog collar people, they are whitewashed cup full of filth inside. That you can see how these are moral. We call them waterless canals. Waterless canal mean immoral people. How immoral they are, you know, these church fathers and other people. So our Father God blesses you.